back with another video. I hope you find it useful and helpful. Since the last video, I have tested out many, many videos. Started with an idea and then extrapolated that idea into the future. And in doing so, I found out that this video is going to get me in a lot of trouble in the future. I said, I better not make that. And I said, what about this one? And same thing. Over and over and over. I've gone over hundreds of themes. Every single one of them, I find out, this is going to land me in severe trouble. And I said, wait a minute. Is there anything that I can say that won't get me in trouble? About 99% of what I would like to say would lead to drastic, severe repercussions in the future. So that begs the question, what is going on here? The last several weeks have been an incredible time. Shocking time. Devastating time. And I'll tell you what has happened. The third dimension has been buried, officially buried, dead and buried. It died actually way back on August 18th, 1999. That's when the dimensional barriers broke down and the fourth dimensional mindset was allowed to flood in here. The dynamics of the fourth dimension had unfettered access to this planet on that very date. I witnessed that date in spirit. I almost died then. And to tell you the truth, in November of 2011, I almost died again. Because from the point when the third dimension was overrun by the fourth on August 18, 1999, the planet, the third dimension, died at that point. And we have been in mourning since then. We've been having the funeral procession, all the eulogies and all the lamenting, all of that. The mourning party has been going on for all this time, all these years. But officially, starting on November 22nd and stretching now through the first part of December, the burial has taken place. This planet has gone through an unbelievable transition where the fourth dimension is now in charge here. Third dimension has died, meaning the United States has died. The United States was the high point of the third dimension. The United States is no longer. The one world order, the global control, has now gained complete control of this planet. And the troubles during November of this year, I almost died. It was so terrible. I don't know how I survived. Was simply the process of leading up to the burial where the dirt would be thrown over the coffin and someone would stick a tombstone up and say R.I.P. rest in peace United States of America third dimension, it's over. So that was a terrible time. I know a lot of people had great difficulty getting through that time, but now it's different now. I mean, it's easier. The shock has worn off a little bit. But it's been replaced by a very strange feeling, and I wonder if any of you have this feeling. I finally identified what this feeling is. I've been struggling with it now for over a week, maybe 2 weeks. The feeling is a feeling of homelessness, like we don't have a home anymore. That's literally what it is. I don't know where to go, what to do, what to say. Nothing, because unless you're a fourth dimensional, you don't have a home here in this world anymore. And since I'm not a fourth dimensional, I feel like I don't have a home here at all. And I'm just waiting for something to take me to a home, place where I really feel at home. It's not this planet anymore. Now, of course, the third dimensionals will resist the fourth dimensional takeover. But it's David versus Goliath, but they'll get stomped. They're putting up a violent protest of anger, of course. They're outraged at what's happened. Who isn't? except the fourth dimensionals are certainly not. They're very happy with the way things are going. Again, I say fourth dimension is, in other videos I've spoken of it, it's all about precision and complexity and control and speed. Do things faster, more precise. Greater control over everything. Greater complexity. Massive bureaucracy. All technocracy. Zero privacy. We know people talk about they're getting rid of privacy. That's a great thing. That's fourth dimensional talk. What it also means, sure, you bring to light certain secrets from the past. But it also means you have no right to privacy whatsoever. Your every association will be logged. Your every movement will be logged. What you read will be logged. Who you talk to, where you worship, how you worship, what you believe, what you do. Every aspect of your life will be monitored. And that's their version of no secrets, no privacy. So, of course, if you want to meditate in some way, that will be known too. Everything will be known about your thoughts, your beliefs, your ideals, your direction, your destiny, everything you want to do, monitored nonstop. That's the fourth dimension. Massive Frankenstein bureaucracy. And like they say, they're just getting started. They say this last, since August 18th, 1999, just imagine what's happened since then. And they say, that's just a drop in the bucket. We're just getting started now. Now we're really going to gain full control over every last aspect of every person on this planet. And believe me, they will do it. I have zero interest in that, so I feel homeless. Of course, with Senate Bill 1867. Essentially, we're under global martial law. This entire planet is under martial law right now. Tacitly. Doesn't even have to be signed into law, because non-action will also make it a law. So there is no more citizenship of the United States of America or anywhere. You're now deemed to be under the auspices of the United Nations, of central world control. Militaries from any country in the world can be invited in to carry out actions in any other country, all at the discretion of the so-called leaders. At their discretion, in other words, a dictatorship. That's exactly what a dictatorship is. It's who is arrested. It depends on the discretion of the leader. That's a dictatorship. So we're already under that. That was the drama that I spoke about. I was told that November 22nd, starting at that date, and then going through into the first part of December, you will see totally unmistakable evidence of the end of the third dimension. It's finished, it's dead, it's buried. The end of your rights. It's a complete catastrophe, what has happened. And so that's why I can't speak up. I feel like I have no more rights. No more protection under the law. And basically we don't. We don't. If you run through things and you follow through, you realize that resistance to the New World Order is deemed an offense worthy of disappearing. It's that simple. And resistance can mean anything. Just basically you want a third dimensional life. You want some privacy. You want to be able to read the books you want, like, watch the videos you like, speak the ideas you want to speak, worship the way you want to worship, focus on the concepts you want to focus on, have the ideals, the destiny you want to talk about, all of those things. They're all tacitly illegal right now. Grounds for being detained by the military. All of it. Basically, the whole planet's been tacitly criminalized. And you have to prove you're not guilty. Instead of being proven that you're guilty beyond a reasonable doubt, now you have to prove you're innocent beyond a reasonable doubt, which means submission to the fourth dimensional way of life and control. And if you don't want to do that, what do you do? That's the question. I certainly believe there will be options for those who don't want that. Now, the third dimensionals will probably try and fight it out, resistance, because that's a third dimensional way. So let's fight it out. Let's, you know, resist. That's the Barabbas equation, as I call it. Same thing happened back in Christ's time in Jerusalem. Fact is that Barabbas recruited Jesus, and he said, look, if you're on my side, we're going to beat the Romans. We can't lose. You see, the Romans had oppression over the Judea at that time. Taxes, and they were ruling. It was a foreign occupation, essentially. Barabbas wanted to radicalize the people so they'd rise up in revolt. So here's Jesus teaching, love your enemy, turn the other cheek. And that caused Barabbas to be furious, because he saw all these people going to see Jesus, and Jesus was teaching them passivity. And that was totally counter to Barabbas' purpose. He wanted to teach them violent revolution. So he said, I got to get Jesus to join my revolutionary movement. Jesus said, thanks, but no thanks. So Barabbas went to the Sanhedrin and said, look, you need to arrest this guy. Brought him up on all sorts of charges and arranged eventually for his arrest. And then what happened, of course, is the revolution did happen. Rome came in and absolutely crushed it. Destroyed all the temples. Razed the country and drove everybody out. Gone. That was Goliath coming in against David there. So right now we have the same situation. The third dimensionals are saying, you know what, we need to oppose all of this. We need to rise up. We can win. We can crush them. Fourth dimensionals are looking at that, and they have their camps ready, their FEMA camps, and all these draconian measures are already there in place waiting for it. They have foreseen all of this. Their aim is to crush the third dimension out of existence. Of course, they say, do no evil. But that's after they get rid of all those who oppose them. And then they say, then we won't do any evil. First, though, we got to get rid of the malcontents. Now, the other option that I have been trying to elucidate here is the fifth dimensional option. A lot of people have been talking about that in various ways over the years, over the decades. Ascension, being taken to a better place, exodus, planetary exodus, relocation. Don't fight it out. Don't have the beans here. Fourth dimension, their intent is aligned with the situation here in such a way that sidestepping the situation is the right, smartest thing to do, the best thing to do, the most helpful, the most loving, etc. That's what Jesus taught back then. He said, look, sidestep it. And they said, how do you do that? And he said, look. He said, I'm coming back at some point in time, and I'm going to help you sidestep the whole situation as it develops at the end of time, end of this cycle. It'll be a very bad situation, and then I will return at that time. I'm going to help you sidestep the whole situation somehow, and you will know at that time what's going on. That's the higher way. So that's certainly what I'm advocating. Not that we know exactly how to sidestep it, and yet if the will is there, if the focus is there, I believe it will be done. But make no mistake, the third dimensionals who are speaking out right now, they certainly have it right. To a large extent. It's just they see the only option they have is resistance. But Jesus said, resist not evil. Love your enemy. It doesn't seem to make much sense to a lot of people here in this world anymore. But if you really examine it, you'll find out it makes a whole lot of sense if relocation is an option. If there's a way to get out of Dodge. And I'm telling you, we need to get out of Dodge, because there will be an event. I call it a precipitating event. Will take place in this world, which will plunge the world into global martial law. Why? Because it's going to crash the financial markets, completely crash them. And at that point in time, the governments of the world will announce that in order to solve the crisis, they have to control the population severely. Be global martial law in place. It's already there. S-1867 has put it there, along with a lot of other laws that have been brought forth recently and decrees and executive orders, etc., all of that. It's to impose a global martial law on this planet to give the world the opportunity to do a reboot. It's like the computer crashing. You need to then reboot it. The world economy is going to crash. Now, precipitating event, I said, is something so drastic that it causes this crash. It's a man-made event. It is not a natural catastrophe. It is not like a tsunami. Obviously, we had the tsunami. The economy is continuing on. Okay, it's a tragedy, but it doesn't collapse the world finances. Man-made event will do it. And that can happen any day, literally. Just like a tsunami, we seem to have no warning. Although psychics and visionaries do have a warning. I saw the Indonesian quake, the day after Christmas quake, about a year in advance, in complete detail. I didn't see the Japanese one for some reason. It's very strange. I didn't see that one. But events can be seen ahead of time. So it doesn't come as a complete surprise. I did see a precipitating event, I don't know, about two years ago. I'm not going to state exactly what it is. But it can happen seemingly without any warning at all. Boom, like that, because it's planned. It's a man-made thing. It's something that they can cause at any moment. So we're sitting here on this December day, thinking everything is okay, and stock markets, struggling, world euro crisis is continuing to bungle along like a train wreck. But literally at any minute, any hour, the precipitating event could take place. The markets could crash, and martial law could very rapidly come about from that. Maybe within a matter of a few days, a few weeks, as the situation unravels, rapidly unravels, and looting takes place in all the markets and stores, martial law will be imposed, believe me. And those people who are seen as malcontents will be rounded up, taken to camps. Now, I'm not down with that. I don't like that. I don't want to be part of that scenario. So, just as a precipitating event could take place anytime, so too could the sidestepping take place at any time. We don't know. But those of you who are very sensitive to world events know that we seem to be going down the rabbit hole very, very far now. Precipitating events, for instance, in World War I, the assassination of the Archduke in wherever he was, Austria-Hungary or somewhere, he was assassinated. Boom, that started World War I. Just like that, because the powder keg was already there. Just right now, the powder kegs are all set in the world. All it takes is a certain event to set it all off completely. Complete destabilization of this planet. course, that's exactly what the fourth dimensionals want. They want to wipe out the third dimension entirely. And with this massive destabilization of martial law, they'll be able then to use their technology to do just that. You'll end up, when the dust clears, you'll end up with this unbelievably draconian bureaucracy, global tyranny, domination of the planet by using high technology, monitoring everything. Complete high-tech police state beyond anything that we are even imagining right now. You will be a slave to that. Now, I know people will say, well, give me liberty or give me death. You know, say they'll fight to the end. Well, how about sidestepping the whole thing, too? What's wrong with that? We're not going to be able to reestablish a third-dimensional structure on this planet. That's over with. It's dead and buried. So resistance doesn't have the meaning that we hope it would have. Just like Barabbas's attempt at the revolution, the eventual revolution happened. What happened? Wiped out Judea, scattered the people to the four winds. What good did that do, you know? It was a catastrophe. Now, some relocated ahead of that time. Maybe they listened to Jesus' teaching and they managed to get out of Dodge. Probably. Probably spread to a different place, parts unknown. Only now it's a global tyranny, not a local provincial one. Total global tyranny. How do you relocate from that? That is the question. Then you have to say, well, it has to be some other planet, probably. Some other dwelling place. Now, for those who are aware of some of the teachings of Scripture, there's a teaching in there when Jesus is ascending. They're saying, where are you going? He said, I'm leaving. They said, you can't leave us. And he said, don't worry. I'll come back. I'm going to prepare a dwelling place for you. And then when I come back, I'm coming back to take you there with me. That's what he's reported as saying. So apparently, there may be other dwelling places. We're finding these Kepler planets all the time. Planets are very suitable for life all over. They say the universe may be absolutely full of them. And that's just in this dimension that we're seeing right now. In other dimensions, there could be, you know, innumerable dwelling situations. So let us not get too myopic and locked into the one vision of resistance. That's it, you know. Because that may not be the only option there is. There's nothing wrong with being aware of that. But if you limit your options too much, sometime you're going to find yourself at a dead end. Maybe sooner than later, the way things are going right now. Because even though it seems to be still, we still seem to be, you know, tottering along. The framework is in place in case a precipitating situation takes place and the world collapses economically, financially. There's a complete wipeout. Everything is in place to smoothly transfer into martial law. It's already there. The training's already happened. I mean, a lot of the defense forces of the U.S. have already trained how to blockade cities, how to arrest American citizens, etc., etc. I had a dream recently where I wanted a train ticket, and I said, I'm an American citizen. They said, I'll go this way. And I went this way, and before I knew it, I was trapped. I said, what happened? I thought everything was fine. It's not fine. Just because you're an American citizen does no longer protect you from the global plan. So we're homeless. We don't have a home. Those who love freedom don't have a home anymore on this planet. And so what do you do when you're homeless? You look for a new home. Just let your awareness expand, become a little bit panoramic right now, so that it has room for this option. We need to find a new home, a place where freedom is valued above everything else. So continue on in these days. Enjoy your Christmas. It's probably the last Christmas that you will really truly enjoy. And after that, the deluge. That's it.